Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today, we're looking at why a Harley Davidson motorcycle so loud. Anyone who's ever witnessed a poker run knows that Harley Davidson motorcycles are really, really loud. And since not everyone thinks that's a good thing, in recent years there have been efforts to stifle them. Straight off the line today, Harley exhaust systems can emit noise as high as 80 decibels, give or take depending on the model. For reference, a typical car when idling emits noise at 35 to 45 decibels and in the high 50s to low 60 decibel levels at freeway speeds. Even something like a 2008 Ford F450 truck only gets as loud as 51 decibels when idling and 68 decibels when traveling at 65 miles per hour. And while you might think that 68 decibels isn't that far off 80 decibels, it's important to understand that the decibel system is logarithmic. In this case, an increase in 10 decibels means that this sound level is 10 times more powerful. So, for instance, 80 decibels would be 10 times more sound pressure than 70 decibels. For further reference, when you're talking with someone in a normal speaking voice, you're usually talking at about 60 decibels, and a lawnmower is usually around 90 decibels, while a typical military jet engine averages about 120 decibels. Needless to say, apart from older models of Harleys that could sometimes reach as high as 90 to 100 decibels, even today's 80 decibels is still really loud. This is far in excess of many cities' noise ordinances, particularly for residential areas, although it complies with EPA regulations for street-level noise. So, why do they make Harleys so loud? For starters, it's difficult to attain the level of quietness one sees in a passenger car in a motorcycle due to little room for bulky mufflers on the bike. That said, loud, powerful-sounding engines have become a signature of this particular brand of motorcycle, leading to the real problem. Many who buy Harleys are not satisfied with the legally regulated stock noise of the engine and instead choose to swap out the existing exhaust systems for straight pipes that don't really mute the engine noise at all. This results in sound that can exceed 100 decibels when revved up. This is extraordinarily loud and could even do damage to human hearing. At just 94 decibels, only 1 hour of exposure can damage your hearing, while at 100 decibels, a mere 15 minutes of exposure will do the trick. Needless to say, the Harley aficionados who make these modifications and don't wear proper hearing protection while riding pay a long-term ear-ringing price for their engines making such a powerful sound. Given this sort of extreme noise pollution, there has been a backlash against noisy bikes in recent years, with many local communities placing restrictions specifically on motorcycle noise and others banning them altogether. One such effort is EPA stamp enforcement. Motorcycles are supposed to display EPA stamps on their chassis and exhaust systems that match each other in order to ensure the systems haven't been modified. While previously enforcement has been lax, more recently communities are mandating compliance, including Denver, Colorado 2007, Boston, Massachusetts 2009, Arvada, Colorado 2009, Portland, Maine 2009, Green Bay, Wisconsin 2009, and the state of California 2010. So strong is the outcry that the president and COO of Harley-Davidson, Jim McGaslin, has posted a message on the company's website in 2009 imploring bikers not to modify their bikes to make them louder. While loud, powerful-sounding engines on Harleys in the past have been something of a selling point, McGaslin noted of a backlash over the noise today is beginning to cause problems. He further implied that unless bikers piped down, regulations and laws would continue to be put in place until Harley-Davidson could no longer sell its loud motorcycles, and the bikes already on the road might ultimately be banned completely. McCaslin has also directly addressed the custom of modifying the exhaust to get more power, saying, "Testing has proven that straight pipes do not necessarily outperform pipes with lower noise levels. Pick the wrong pipes and you can severely reduce your horsepower and/or your torque. And while you're doing it, you'll awaken the sleeping giant of social concern that lives next door to all of us." Harley-Davidson has also taken steps to eliminate the modifications by no longer shipping racing exhaust systems that can work on street models to dealers. Beyond the argument over increasing power, enthusiasts in favor of loud exhaust systems often claim that their loud pipes save lives, meaning that because they can be heard, drivers of cars and trucks are alerted to their presence and won't hit them. While certainly anyone who's driven a motorcycle around is well aware of the fact that many larger passenger vehicles simply don't notice the motorcycles in their blind spots and the like, antagonists note, however, that the majority of fatal crashes involving motorcycles were caused by the motorcycle rider, at least according to a 2007 report by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. In the report, it was noted that 45% of fatal motorcycle crashes are single vehicle, meaning the motorcycle alone, and that among the remaining 55%, in nearly 75% of the two vehicle crashes, the motorcyclist was deemed responsible. That said, the classification of single vehicle crashes that accounts for 45% of fatal motorcycle crashes does include run-off-road collisions. The debate rages on. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a like below, it helps out. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Over there on the right are a couple of examples of our other videos, so be sure to check those out. And thank you for watching.